We already on?
Yep, we're on.
How do I look? How's my hair?
The competition. Let me start again. It's just like so. Just cut that.
Nah, that's a bad answer. You're gonna have to cut me out there.
No pressure. There's a ton of pressure. No, you're lying.
I'm not used to this.
Ready?
Yeah. Just
okay.
Hoping you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your
name. If I was to describe Mike in one word, it would probably be consistent.
Reliable.
Mentor.
I would describe Mike as steady.
Coach.
Mike, one word. Enjoyable.
Always consistent.
Very supportive.
Even keel.
Selfless.
Demonstrative.
Servant.
And frugal.
One, I think, which everybody would use is he is very frugal.
Mike is frugal. He's very wise.
Friendly. You know, he's always smiling and has a lot of fatherly characteristics. Grandfatherly, maybe. Kidding, Mike.
I swear I live.
I think there's a few people in your life that have an extremely large impact, and for me, Mike was one of those people. When I was younger and impressionable, coming to school, Mike ended up being my coach, and I learned more from him, perhaps as a husband and a father, by observing how he treated his kids, how he was with his wife, the things that were important to him. And then how he treated all of us as people and players. I think in that regard, I think as a mentor for a young man finding his way, Mike was a great example of that.
I go back to 1980-81 basketball team. Jamie, Wayne, Sam, Jerry, myself, and the dynamic duo of Andy Sass and Darren Weeder. We loved playing for you, and it was the most joyous seasons I ever had playing in sports.
When I was playing for him, Bev and Mike asked me to babysit, and they came home one evening, and I was down in the basement watching a game, and Aaron was out on the front yard playing. They weren't very happy with that, but so I think they're just thrilled that they still have their family intact.
One thing I will recall, because many people don't remember this or know this, but we know Mike is basketball coach, soccer coach, tennis coach, AD. Mike was also a head track coach, and I was his assistant back in the 80s. But Mike yelled too much in track, so we told him to go to another sport.
I transferred into Roberts back in early 80s, and that was Mike's first year as the men's soccer coach. And he was steady, just his highs aren't too high and his lows aren't too low. And he's that way in life, and he's that way as a coach.
One phrase Mike used to always say back then was, this would be a nice feather in your cap if we were to win this game. I looked how he coached, and in some ways I try to copy that.
He practices what he preaches. He's really just always there for his coaches.
You know, anytime you need him, just willing to just drop what he's doing, drop of a hat, you know, and he's willing to help you out.
You know, just day in, day out, hard worker, always there, first one in the morning, and just extremely consistent in all he does.
Well, Mike's been very important in my career as a mentor. The story I like to tell is that I applied for this job Before I was obviously qualified and didn't get it, and Mike was willing to kind of be a mentor even before I worked here. Kind of helped me out with what things I needed to work on, experience that I needed to garner, and then when the opportunity came up again, you know, I was fortunate to be prepared and make that next step. So I certainly wouldn't be here without his guidance and wisdom and leadership.
Mike gave me my first opportunity to get involved in college soccer as a GA here at Roberts. He also provided me, him and his wife provided me with a place to live when I was a GA. So he's had a big influence on my coaching career and given me some great opportunities.
I learned a lot from Mike about how to be supportive and to be a good servant leader. He was wonderful with his kids that way. And I wasn't always like that, and I tried to incorporate a little bit more of Mike into the way I coach.
He's really made me think more about the game besides the X's and O's, besides the motivating, besides getting to the kids, made me think more about the other thing, development of the players, the character, the spiritual part of the game, more so than I have in the past. So I think that's been good for me, you know, in my later years as coaching. So I think that's helped me a lot.
I wanted to say, you know, thank you to Mike. You know, he gave me the opportunity to start working here. I was a young professional looking for a job, and he gave me that trust, and you know, I respect him and thank him for that. So, Mike, thanks for all the work you've done.
I've really been struck by the impact that Mike has had on so many student athletes and coaches, and I just think it's quite a legacy.